अस्सलाम वालेकुम व्यूअर्स, आई वेलकम यू टू माय चैनल एग्रो कंसल्टेंट ज़िया। आई एम सैयद ज़िया हुसैन। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग। आई डोंट बिलीव ऑन डेफिनेशंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग दैट आर अवेलेबल इन लिटरेचर। अवेलेबल डेफिनेशंस डिनाई एंड रिजेक्ट द यूज ऑफ सिंथेटिक फर्टिलाइजर्स इन ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग। Kindly review about these definitions. I claim and challenge that organic farming is farming of crops where use of synthetic fertilizer may or may not be applied. Viewers, before going to details, I will request you to subscribe my channel. Never forget to comment in comment box. Your comments and criticism is highly precious for me. There are 17 essential elements that are required and uptaken by plants. Three essential elements, oxygen, carbon and hydrogen, these are taken by plants from water or air. The remaining 14 essential elements are divided into different groups. Three are macronutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus and potash, which are applied in huge amounts or in larger amounts. Three more nutrients, sulfur, calcium and magnesium, these are also applied in comparatively larger amount, but their amounts are not comparable with the amounts of nitrogen, phosphorus and potash. Eight other elements are called micronutrients. These are required only in trace or minor amounts. Viewers, all these essential elements are taken up by plant by roots and are converted into organic compounds or molecules. For example, phosphorus becomes part of DNA. Viewers, kindly pay attention. Urea is synthetic organic fertilizer. Believe that it is synthetic, but it is organic fertilizer. Was the first ever organic molecule which are produced or manufactured in industry. I have two questions. If urea is organic fertilizer, why the world scientists and agrarians deny the use of urea in organic farming? Because they deny the use of synthetic fertilizers. Organic fertilizers are recommended in organic farming. Urea is completely organic fertilizer. Then why it is rejected? My second question. Plant is a natural factory which can convert our essential nutrients into organic nutrients or organic compounds. Animals cannot convert them into organic form. Animal or human body can only take organic nutrients. If I claim that synthetic fertilizers may be applied in organic farming, then what is organic farming? If we will apply synthetic fertilizers, then how we will define it as organic farming? Actually, organic farming is the farming of crops without the use of toxins or pesticides. Let's go to the real world. Europe will reject Pakistani mangoes if these contains toxins and pesticides. But these mangoes will not be rejected if synthetic fertilizers are applied to grow them. Because toxins are hazardous to human body, but fertilizers are not hazardous to human body. Human body need all these essential nutrients which are taken up by plants. If we do not provide synthetic fertilizers to plant, it will cause nutrient deficiency and plant will produce poor in nutrient food. Poor in nutrient food will result in disease affected populations which will have highly weak immune system. Agrarians and world scientists are requested to kindly correct and review their literature and definitions. Stop use of toxins in organic farming, but not the use of synthetic fertilizers. All previous stories about organic farming are based on assumptions made by farmers, but not based on scientific reasoning and research. This bad practice will cause zinc, boron, iron and other essential nutrient deficiencies in human population. I reject all definitions and practices of organic farming. I recommend organic farming as toxin-free or pesticide-free farming. Otherwise, organic farming according to your definitions will be the farming of red planet. If we apply synthetic fertilizers in organic farming, not a single fertilizer will be present in our food as a toxic agent or hazardous molecule. even will not be present in inorganic form. For example, if DAP is applied to a crop, DAP will not be present in our food. If we apply toxins to plants, toxins will be diagnosed in our food. For example, deltamethrin, lambda, trichlorophos, lufenuron. I simply justify it that if we apply DAP, a synthetic fertilizer, it will be present in plant structure as organic phosphorus. Not a single gram of pure DAP will be diagnosed in plant structure. Phosphorus is the backbone of DNA. If we will not apply required essential phosphorus in the form of DAP, how it will be possible for plant to uptake essential phosphorus? Dear viewers, I will conclude with a challenge and claim that organic farming is a farming of crops without the use of toxins and pesticides, where synthetic fertilizer may or may not be applied. I am sure you will agree with my opinion and with my claims. I will wait for your suggestions and criticism. Kindly subscribe my channel, share my video and like it. I will wish you organic life, where our essential nutrients and elements are available for you in organic form. God bless you with toxin-free food. I will summarize organic farming. In organic farming, we will not use antibiotics, we will not use toxic chemicals, and we will not apply irrigation water polluted with heavy metals. We will not use GMO crops engineered with genes producing toxic chemicals. Farming which is being practiced by our farmers in recent days, I will define this farming as prehistoric farming rather than organic farming. In prehistoric farming, we will not use any type of chemicals and any type of synthetic fertilizers. We will use animal dung, poultry manure and organic compounds. We will not define it as organic farming. It is actually prehistoric farming. Thank you for sparing your precious time. Be happy. Allah Hafiz.